Today, I'm going to show you how to edit a simple cinematic sequence in the free version of DaVinci Resolve. Step by step, from start to finish. Each and every one of you can do this, I promise. And I believe in you. And then at the end of the video, you'll know exactly how to turn a bunch of clips into a cool cinematic sequence. Like this one, for example. Okay, let's do it. But before we start editing, we need footage, of course. Now, sometimes you'll hear filmmakers or videographers say, "We'll fix it in post," meaning that, for example, a mistake was made while filming, and that they'll try to fix that mistake in the editing process, in DaVinci Resolve. Now, you can fix a lot in DaVinci Resolve, but if you want to have a good time editing, make sure you get it right on location while filming. It'll save you a lot of frustration. Just make sure that you can start with some decent footage. And I'm not saying that you need movie quality footage. No, not at all. We're beginners here, right? We're learning. But just some decent footage, that's all. And I'll link a video in the description on how I film a simple cinematic sequence. Definitely go check it out. Okay, and then when you have footage, open Resolve, start a new project, and first go to the project settings. Now, there's a lot of information here, a bit too much for beginners. But don't worry, all you have to do now is set the project resolution. That's it. So that basically means HD, 1080 or 4K. Usually these days it will be 4K, but 1080 is also totally fine, of course. And a quick tip, if your computer struggles while editing 4K, just leave it on 1080 HD and then change it again when you're done, right before you export the video. But when you edit in 1080, Resolve will run a lot smoother. And then the first thing I always do is import all my footage in the media pool. That's where you can see all your video clips. So right click here in the media pool, select import media, and then just go to the folder containing your video clips. Select them all and import. Or you can also drag all your clips from that folder to the media pool or directly on the timeline even. And then they will be automatically imported. And as soon as you import media, Resolve will ask you if you want to change the frame rate of your project. Remember, in the project settings, we only set the project resolution and not the frame rate? Well, this is why. Resolve will automatically set your project's frame rate to the correct frame rate so that it matches the frame rate of your footage. So just click change, and then it will happen automatically. Now, it is of course important that all your footage was shot in the same frame rate and that you don't want to use slow motion. In this video, I'm not gonna talk about different frame rates and slow motion and things like that. We're gonna keep it simple. So we have all our clips on the timeline now, right? And if that's not the case, well, just select them all in the media pool and drag them on the timeline here. That's this panel, this is the timeline. And straight away, we can see that there's way too many clips. So it's time to cull. What I always do is I just go over all the clips, I watch them, and I delete the ones that I don't need. It's as simple as that. And that doesn't mean that I'm gonna use all the ones that will be left, but I just wanna get rid of the bad ones. Out of focus, bad composition, shaky, anything that doesn't look good. Just delete them all. And that's basically it for this step. And then next, I want to create a rough version of my sequence. And that basically means put clips in the right order so that the sequence tells a little story, you know? So usually for sequences like this where I film myself, I have clips of myself doing stuff and then clips of the surroundings. And I just start by laying the puzzle. But what always works is to start a sequence with some establishing shots. Some cool shots of the surroundings, so that the viewer knows where the video is taking place. And I also like to start with those shots because they're perfect to put a title on. We'll do that later in the video. So let's say two or three of those establishing shots, right? To show the viewer where we are. And then maybe the first shot of myself, where I walk into the frame, to introduce the main character, so to speak. And that scene where I walk to the edge of the water and then look at the view, I shot that scene from different angles, and that's really important. Again, go check out my video on how I shoot a cinematic sequence like this, because it's super important that you get those different angles. Because if you have those different angles of the same scene, you can, for example, go from this clip, a wide shot, to this one, a low close-up shot. And then maybe here we can cut this clip and put a clip in between of what I'm looking at. So we're going to split a clip. Just put the playhead where you want to make a cut, where you want to split the clip, and then you can use the blade tool here to split the clip, or hit the shortcut for splitting a clip. I mapped it to the D key and it makes a cut, see? But you can remap shortcuts wherever you want. Just go here to keyboard preferences and then just find split clip and remap it to a key of your preference. And then we'll put that clip of the water in between those two. And then after the clip of the water, maybe we'll cut back to me looking at the view. Same low angle close up. And then see how I turn my head here a bit? Well, maybe it's nice to cut it there again and then put another clip of the view, but a different view, a different part of the view. So make a cut. Again, use the blade tool or hit the shortcut. And I'm gonna do it right after I turn my head. And then I'll add some more of those shots of the surroundings. And then after those shots, let's cut back to the same low shot of myself. And this is what we have now, see? Just by splitting clips and putting other clips in between. Move them around, that's it. And then here at the end, see how I turn around? Remember that I shot that scene from different angles? Well, I also filmed it from the back. That's this clip, see? This is where I turn around. So now I can make this cool cut when I turn around. I'm just gonna split the clip right when I turn around, and then this clip too, delete the parts I don't need with the delete key, and then put them together. And then it looks something like this. And if the timing is not right, you can always trim your clips a bit, because when you make a cut, or when you split a clip, the part that you delete is not gone. It's still there. Just put the mouse on the edge of the clip and then it'll turn into this symbol, this icon, see? And then when you drag, you can reveal the part that you deleted again or remove a bit more. So you can still tweak everything at any moment by trimming the clips. And if you want to trim a bit more accurately, it's always best to disable the magnet here so that the playhead and the cuts and trims don't snap into place. And that's how I create a rough sequence. First put the clips in the right order and then split clips so that you can put other clips in between. Trim clips by dragging the edges and well, that's basically it. That's all the tools you need to create a basic cinematic sequence. Okay, and then when you have a rough sequence, a rough little story, it's time for music. Because we want to edit our sequence to music so that it flows nicely. There's also no dialogue or anything, so music is super important. Not only to create atmosphere, but also to know where you want your cuts. Now, what kind of music you use, that's totally up to you, of course. But if I may suggest something, I get my music from Audio, the sponsor of this video. And they've just released a super cool new AI feature that will help you to find the perfect song. It's called Hans... Is it called Hans AI or Hans AI? I forgot to ask how to pronounce it. Hans? 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 German? I don't know, but it doesn't matter. I'll call it Hans AI for now. Auf Deutsch. Now, how does it work? Well, instead of using filters to find your song, all you need to do is tell it what you need with a text prompt and it will find the perfect song for you. For example, here's a few prompts that I tried. Find music that feels like an icy winter landscape. And then it gave me a few options and this was one of them. Sounds great, right? Or this one, find music like the movie Interstellar. And this was one of the results. It's really cool and it will 100% speed up your workflow. And you can get unlimited access to Hans AI for 70% off your first year of Audio Pro when you use my link and code in the description. So that's your first year for just $59. Go check it out, and of course, thank you so much, Audio, for sponsoring this video. And then once you've found the perfect song, drop it on the timeline under your video clips and just play your sequence. So put the playhead at the beginning of the sequence, hit spacebar and let it play. And now it's basically a matter of feeling when you should cut to the next clip based on the beats and the pace of the music. So for the first clip, for example, I feel like this is when there needs to be a cut to the next clip. The first clip is also way too long, so you know, it needs to be shortened. So all you need to do is put the playhead there and trim the clip, or split the clip and delete the part, and then move all the other clips. Or you can also set the playhead to where you want to cut and hit the shortcut for ripple trim and to playhead. By default, it's shift plus option plus bracket on a Mac, but I've remapped it to S, the S key. And when you hit that shortcut, it will trim the clip and move all the other clips behind it automatically to the left. And then you just need to keep doing that for all the other clips. So play it again and try to feel where you want the next cut, where you want to cut to the next clip. And listen to the music. There's no rules for this. Maybe some people would make the first clip last a few seconds longer than what I did here, you know? It's something you have to learn by doing, and just do that for every clip, every cut, but keep it simple. And then when you're done and you feel like one of the cuts is still, it feels a little bit off or something, well, you can always tweak it again, of course. Disable the magnet and then put the mouse over a cut, and see, then you get this double icon. And this means that you can move the cut to the left or the right without creating an opening. So it just moves the cut. And when you're done with your whole sequence, don't worry about the length of the music track. Just trim it to the same length as the video, right click at the end, and add a crossfade to 0 so that the music dies out. And that's it. And for the video, just do the same so that it goes to black. And that's how I trim all my clips to the correct length. First of all, because I don't want super long clips, they need to be shortened. But also, I want the cuts in the correct position, that it matches the beat of the music or the pace of the music. That's the whole idea here, that your sequence flows with the music. Okay, and then we have color grading. Now look, DaVinci Resolve is a super powerful color grading software, but this is a beginner video, and so I'm just gonna show you a super simple way to do it. It's also how I do it when I don't have time to actually color grade. So I just drop an adjustment clip on my first video clip. You can find the adjustment clip here in Effects. Then put the playhead over it and go to the color page down here. I just check if the color temperature and the tint looks okay. And you can do a lot by just adjusting color temperature and tint. And then if you're using DaVinci Resolve Studio, so this is something you can't do in the free version, but in DaVinci Resolve Studio, I add the film look creator here from effects, and I start playing around with the sliders and presets until I found a look that I like. That's basically it. And if you're in the free version, just use a LUT. And a LUT is basically a color preset that you drop on your video and it changes the colors. I always use one of my LUTs because it's fast and easy, but of course you can use any LUT you want, it doesn't matter. Just remember that LUTs are not magic. Normally, you should use them in combination with actual color grading, but because we're beginners here and we don't have time, just use the LUT. So first look for a tutorial on how to use LUTs, and then, you know, import your LUTs, the ones that you like here in LUTs, then create a new node here by right-clicking, connect it like this, and then go to LUTs and apply the LUT that you like. See, and it changes the colors instantly. And if the LUT is too strong, if the effect is too strong, go to key down here, and this is where you can lower the output of the LUT. So basically lower the intensity. And that's it. I'm gonna say it again. Keep it simple. And then finally, titles or text. And I'm gonna show you an example here. What looks more cinematic to open a video? This? Or this? And maybe you don't like the title or the colors that I used here, but doesn't it just add something more cinematic to the video. There's a reason why movie titles always have a specific design and colors and animations. A lot of work goes into creating movie titles. But don't worry, you don't have to put too much effort into it. Because DaVinci Resolve has a lot of built-in titles that you can tweak and customize. Most of the time, just choosing the right font and color already does a lot to the look of your video. But if you want more, some cooler animations, well, you can buy plugins. There's a ton out there. And some are even free, by the way. I always use Motion VFX for my videos, so if you like the titles and motion graphics in my videos, I'll put a link in the description, you can go check it out. And that's basically it, guys. Like, you only need 0.0001% of all the tools and features that DaVinci Resolve offers to create a cool cinematic sequence. Cut, trim, move around your clips, and that's basically it. And now it's up to you. I would give you homework for next week, but maybe that's like a bit too far. No, just try it out and I'm sure you can do this. 100%. Thank you so much for watching and see you in the next one.